this video, did a deadly plague destroy Neolithic Europe? And what could this have to do with us modern humans? While plague is re-emerging, according to certain scientists and health organizations. So this is the video. These are the Bronze Age plague sites. So latest 4,000 years ago, the groups, peoples, coming from North America, taking over Western Eurasia. This is Europe, and this is Western Eurasia. This is Altai Mountains. This is Kazakhstan, and this is Mongolia, and this is China. So, in fact, it is even including Central Eurasia. So these were plague sites during the Bronze Age, brought by the newcomers coming from the Americas, North America. So this is another illustration, but it pretty much says the same. Again, China, Mongolia, Kazakhstan. So you see it's pretty much all of Eurasia. One of the incoming routes in my videos, and that I know from haplogroup movements, haplogroup trees, is upriver, Yenisei River, going down to Altai and even into China. So this is, I repeat it on other occasions, Altai Mountains is very strategical to remember and keep an eye on, including to discover the plague sites in the Bronze Age. So that's early Bronze Age, certainly more than 4,000 years ago. So this seems to give periods that the researchers knew these places were plague sites. Our immune systems are not trained anymore against plague and etc. for roughly 70 years or more, because roughly 70 years ago we had effective antibiotics against plague. So whenever there would be a case, the surveillance and control would treat and eliminate plague with this effective antibiotics. So the population was never again, and also plague was controlled, very much controlled since then. It only started to re-emerge say roughly the last 20 years or a bit more, and it's now that scientists and health organizations are warning that it is re-emerging, not just increasing cases, because increasing cases is for over 20 years, especially in Africa, but all over the world. So now scientists health organizations are talking about re-emergence of plague. So, but still, our immune systems were not trained for roughly this period. The same for several other bacterial diseases, pathogens. There, the period that we are not trained is in some cases over 90 years. The inventor of antibiotics, Fleming, warned right away for antibiotic etc. resistance in case of any abuse. Exaggerated use. I still have an article warning about critical resistance being near. The article being from before the year 2000, years before. World Health Organization clearly did ring the alarm bell last 2016. And held emergency meetings that involved industry, and such emergency meeting was repeated in 2019. But we all know that by the end of the year 2019, a new coronavirus broke through. A breakthrough, I see it as a breakthrough, because there were coronavirus epidemics before, but they never turned into a pandemic. So this is a breakthrough to the world of a coronavirus. I will describe in the next videos how the coronavirus crisis, perfect storm, double threat, as coined by certain health organizations could have been triggered, caused, or aggravated by general antibiotic resistance, what we are talking about. And this even while antibiotics theoretically have no effect on viruses in general. Antibiotics have effects against bacteria, etc., not against viruses. And this explanation, this description I will make, has to do with viruses as innate immunity primers against threats, not by humans at least, but by their immunity systems. I'm very worried that our resistance and immunity has historically dropped so low that fungi that have historically never caused infections or crisis now seem to threaten to cause one or more health crises. A general sign of weakened immunity, herd immunity, is a risk for any pathogen and even of symbiotic bacteria to cause one or more simultaneous health crises. And this independent of presenting antibiotic resistance or not. We urgently need to understand how we can increase our resistance and immunity that is historically low against plague, etc., without the need for very dangerous training. An epidemic or a pandemic is also a very dangerous training. In the case of plague, no vaccine is, let's say, allowed they exist, they are not a load. And because it are life attenuated vaccines. And I would like to mention that even a vaccination against plague or whatever is a training of the immune system. A training against a not very dangerous pathogen, because the pathogen is weakened before it is used as a vaccination. Certain scientists think or claim that almost all of the former population of Western Eurasia in the Neolithic were wiped out somewhere before 4000 BP because they had not enough resistance at the time against plague, because they were never trained against plague. That's what these scientists think or claim. The newcomers were trained against it and they brought it with them from North America, mostly North America. I will handle in coming videos parallels, similarities between other periods of plague and not just this Neolithic plague, hypothesized plague. I will handle similarities for us to understand when there is risk for a plague epidemic or pandemic. Right now we only have cases rising, but according to scientists and health organizations, plague as an epidemic or a pandemic is re-emerging. For me it's very clear that in these periods, Neolithic, the humans had much more resistance and immunity against plague for several reasons. We should remember that plague cases are on the rise for some decades, and so is the resistance of the plague bacteria. It's independent, eh? Well, it should be independent. So the cases are rising. I said it wrong. I will correct. The cases are rising for, let's say, 20 or more years, but there is no question, risk or epidemic or pandemic right now, just cases are rising. But so is the resistance of bacteria against antibiotics that were and are first line used against these cases that are rising. We also should take note that certain first line antibiotics against plague are not anymore freely available on the market. You have to request it. So in the case of plague, it's not in time, because you have to treat yourself with efficient antibiotics in the first 24 hours. So that's one of the reasons why plague is so dangerous and mortal. Knowing that plague is re-emerging, I cannot see another reason than these first line antibiotics proven to be effective suffer some kind of loss of effectiveness because of bacteria, plague bacteria, becoming more resistant against these antibiotics. The other explanation would be a lack of production capacity, but for me it's not realistic, it's not a realistic explanation, since mass quantities used in agriculture still are produced. They are digits more in mass, in weight, in production, they're even expressed in tons, while one dose against plague is in 1 gram, of the order of 1 gram. So they're used in mass in agriculture, very much violating the recommendations of health organizations that are extremely worried about antibiotic resistance in general. The health organizations, the United Nations organization, do not have it the way they want it to be. They talk about the One Health principle, and that has to do with use in agriculture. And this situation could lead, or have led already, to a range of breakthroughs, including of Yersinia pestis. Ancient Britons, going back to the Neolithic, plague brought by the newcomers to the island. But this article is about Britons, but it's regarding Western Eurasia and the whole of Eurasia, as I showed in the graphic above. Video. In the Neolithic in Britain, one of the megalith structures, Stonehenge, was built. But even the builders of Stonehenge mysteriously were overturned in just a few centuries after the construction of Stonehenge. So they are an example. This conclusion has to do with ancient DNA research. So 90% of the population after this turnover is composed by the newly arrived Central European originating population, known as the Beaker people. And I will argue and give proofs that they do not come from Central European originating populations, that they do come from North America, and that including the Central European originating populations do come also from North America. There's no evidence for large-scale conflict. As I said before, the population that was before and after the turnover event were related, at least to some extent. And what the researchers here try to insinuate is that plague could, it would be an explanation for, let's say, the extinction of the former populations without violence. But I think plague could be involved, but total warfare dominance of the newcomers is also a reason. It's like a blitzkrieg, like a blitz invasion. It was so overwhelming, or the males were killed so quickly that you don't find evidence of conflict. So these incoming groups gained control of best land and resources, and if there was any of the former Neolithic population left, it was marginalized. David Reich says they had no longer access to the females of their own population. So this is the explanation that they come up with, the possibility that the native Neolithic population of Britain had no resistance to some continental European diseases, but that's very strong. It's more understandable if it could come from the Americas. This could be even an argument, a small argument for the newcomers to come from the Americas. So it is people that arrived in mass and brought plague with them. I'm not sure if this is so interesting, but someone who wants to really understand this more profoundly should assist a free video of David Reich on YouTube. Ancient DNA and the New Science of the Human Past, March 3, 2021. Very interesting. It's a long video, just over 1 hour. And again, it shows that the people in Western Europe, but all over Asia, all over Eurasia, come from the Americas. Of course this is surprising. Nobody expected this, and I dare to say that the public, humans in general, do not even know of this. Even if the science, the research was done in 2017, I suppose that David Reich first came out in 2021. It is so inconvenient for science that was built up for almost 200 years to be confronted with such a, let's say, difference. I will show in other videos that these incomers had certain knowledges that they needed for their navigation. So this is carved in the pillars. It's marked, highlighted, these animals are there in relief, and they present areas in the sky, night sky, that present stars that are important for navigation. Like say, let's say the North Star. It's very specially marked with this symbol, this and this. It's like kind of a halter. Eh? It's a strong symbol that returns. Returns all over the world, because they traveled all over the world. They had to travel from the Americas to the rest of the world. So, more about this in the next video. I probably go back to the Sintashta, which is one of the groups that brought plague, that is detected in their fossils, because we're talking about fossils of at least 4,000 years ago, that learn about their culture, and that also learn that they were buried with chariots with wheels, exactly the wheels that would fit into the cart ruts we find in Malta and in many other countries of, and even continents all over the world. So this is the axis and this is the wheels. They are of course totally disorientated. Here again, the wheel and the axis broken, it's still there. This is the axis and metal weapons. So they were advanced people. This is over 4,000 years ago. This is a part, this is a pot, this is a part of an axis. And this shows where the plague foci are, and this is where these groups, these newcomers, came in from the Americas, amongst others by the gyre, North Atlantic gyre, amongst others. There's another entry here. There's still other entries. Again, Altai as an incoming point of the newcomers, and here as more or less St. Petersburg, another income. And they use this sea to come in with the North Atlantic gyre. So okay, place plague foci again, plague foci, showing just the same as I just said. Well, this will be for next videos, where we will show more about the spoked wheels produced in rather industrial complexes by these incomers that brought the plague to make war chariots. But it's the same type of wheel that we expect for the cart ruts, only more robust and more heavyweight than the war chariots, of course. So but that's for the next videos. Thank you very much for watching. Bye for now.